What is a microcontroller? A microcontroller is the brains of an embedded device such as your cell phone, TV, watch, or just about every single electronic device that you own. If we take a step back and think about what a microcontroller does, it simplifies to taking inputs and creating outputs. Let's take a simple embedded device like a TV remote. A simple TV remote will have 10 buttons for channels 0 through 9, 2 buttons for volume up and down, 2 buttons for channels up and down, and a power button. That means we would need a microcontroller with 15 inputs. As for outputs, a basic IR infrared remote works by blinking a IR LED with a very specific pattern at the TV. This means we only need one output. A computer programmer would then flash code to the microcontroller that contains the pattern to blink when a certain key is pressed. A microcontroller by itself is not capable of much more than just doing some basic math, reading an input, and setting an output. Reading an input and setting an output is one of the most basic functions of a microcontroller and is normally called General Purpose Input Output, or for short, GPIO. If you have a microcontroller that is fast enough, you probably wouldn't need much more. You could just constantly read inputs and set outputs to create the signals you want. Reading and setting signals like this is called bit banging. This is intense for the processor because it runs it constantly without giving it a break. This is bad practice and should only be done when it is absolutely necessary because it is error prone and wasteful of resources. If bit banging is so bad, what else can you do? Most, if not all, microcontrollers have peripherals. Peripherals are dedicated chips that are designed to handle specific information. Peripherals are usually the deciding factor when buying a new microprocessor, along with speed and price. Peripherals make coding much easier for the programmer and help make the system more efficient by offloading the work to the peripheral rather than the microcontroller itself. A microcontroller by itself is a chip. In order to actually use a microcontroller, you're going to need a printed circuit board, an etched circuit board, or a breadboard. You'll also need a programmer and, dependent on the microcontroller, a crystal. Fortunately, the manufacturers of microcontrollers have made it easy for first-time users by creating training boards. They normally aren't called training boards, but they all have the same basic function. They provide the programmer a way to flash and debug the program over a USB cable. Training boards have headers that are connected to the microcontroller, which allows you to connect the wires without having to solder directly to the chip. Other than prototyping, a software developer won't like having to hardwire a circuit straight to the training board whenever they want to add and test the functionality to the software. It's difficult and easily falls apart. This problem is solved with expansion boards. Expansion boards are printed circuit boards that provide a specific function to the training board, hence the name expansion board. Expansion boards are designed in a way that they are able to be stacked on top of each other. A simple one can provide relays to allow the training board to turn on and off high-power devices. Or complex ones can have another microcontroller communicating to the training board. Depending on the training board, they have different names. Arduino calls them shields, Texas Instrument calls them booster packs, and Beagle Board calls them capes. The company that creates their training board probably has their own integrated development environment, or IDE. It will normally come with a compiler, flasher, and debugger at least. As a programmer, you will type up your program in their IDE, and once you're ready to test it out, you'll connect their training board to your computer and flash it. You'll then be able to step through your program while it runs on the microcontroller. It is not absolutely necessary to use their IDE that the board recommends, but it makes it easier. Don't forget to press that like button if you found this video useful, and feel free to subscribe if you want to see more tutorials like this.